Hi friends, welcome to Competitive Exams Material. In this channel, in this video, I'm going to explain 6 different ways to iterate over HashMap in Java. So what are the 6 different ways to iterate over HashMap in a Java? Okay, so this video will be helpful for the beginners as well as, this question might be asked for the interview, in the interview for between 0 to 3 years of experience. And at the same time, this will be useful for experienced people as well, how to iterate over a hash map in Java. Okay, so let's see the first method. What is the first method is by using key set. Okay, so by using key set, what we can do is, we'll get the key from the hash map, and by using key, we'll get the value. Okay. By passing the key to the map, it will give you a value. We have a method called get. Okay. Let's write a simple program to look into this. So I am creating a new class. Map iterator demo. I am calling it as map iterator demo. And I am writing a main method. Okay. And then in this main method, first let me create a map. So how do we create a map? So map, just pass key comma value. So which type of map we are creating? Okay. I am creating a map called integer comma string. So I am calling it as a fruit map is equal to new hash map of okay. So we are getting the compilation error, right? Let's fix this compilation error. Map cannot be resolved to a type. Why? Because we have imported hash map, but we didn't import it map. So let me import the map as well. Okay, I have imported the map as well. Now add the element to the map. Okay, fruit map dot put. First, what is the first fruit? Let's say mango. And then what is the other fruit? Let's say apple. What is the third fruit? Banana. So we call this third fruit as banana. And the fourth fruit as orange. Okay. So this is how we add the elements to the map. First we have created a map and then we have added elements to the map. So what is the first method? Using key set. Okay. So I am saying this method name as key set iteration. I am calling this method as key set iteration. So what I am doing is I am creating a method called key set iteration. Okay, and I am passing the value of fruit map. Okay, this should return a map again. Why? Because I'll be printing that map in the below. So let me call that as integer comma string. Or just what I'll do is instead of returning, right, I'll be printing there only. In the key set iteration only, I'll print. So first create a key set iteration map. Okay, key set iteration method and pass fruit map. So I'm creating a method key set iteration. Let's say quick fix. And here we'll get an option called create method. Just click on that. So you need not get tension about anything. Why? Because Eclipse will create a method for you as per your requirement. Okay. So now you have fruit map, right? No, what we need to do is just loop through this map. Okay, loop through this map by using for each. So here it is what? Iterable. Okay, so iterable is nothing but fruit map. I am passing this map. Okay, so in this map, what type of values we are having? Okay, in this map, what type of values we are having? So just call key set method on this. Why? Because we are using key set. When we say fruit map dot key set, so in map we have a method called key set. What with this? What this key set will return? It will return key values of that map. So what are the key values of this map? Integers. So here iterable type should be integer. Okay, and let's name this element as fruit. Okay, fruit ID, or we can call it as fruit ID. Okay, why? Because since it's an integer, huh? So for integer fruit ID, fruit map dot key set. Now just print sysout key value equals to, it will return key. What is the key here? Fruit ID. Okay, and now print the value of this map. Okay, key value and value. So the value will be, pass this key to the map which will give you value. So what is the map here? Fruit map. So fruit map dot get. When we say get on this fruit map, by passing the key, it will return you the values. So here we have two different methods which we need to learn as part of this video. First one is key set. Okay, as part of this method we need to learn two methods. Key set, what this key set will return? It returns a set view of keys contained in this map. That means it will return all the keys within the map. Here all the keys means what? 1, 2, 3, 4. So that is the reason I am iterating on this key set. Okay, and whenever I iterate on this key set, what I'll get? I'll get keys, and then I am printing the value of fruit ID. Next, how do I get the value out of key? So when we say get of key, so we have a method in the map called get. Okay, what is the signature of this method? We get object of key. When we pass key, it will return V, that is value of that map. For a particular key, it will get the value. So returns the value to which the specified key is mapped, or null if this map contains no mapping for the key. So if there is a value in the map for a particular key, it will return. If there is no value, it will return null. Okay, so this is the first method of iterating through the key set method. Let's run this program and see the output. You see, key value equal to 1, value equal to mango. Key value equal to 2, value equal to apple. Key value equal to 3, value equal to banana. Okay, so this is the first method. Hope you understand how to write the first method. Now let's go to the second method. So let's see the second method using iterator. Okay, by using iterator also we can iterate through the map. So this method is more suitable when we want to remove some data during iteration. So this is the main advantage if you use iterator. Okay, so let's see the example. So in the second one, by using iterator, okay, just write a method called iterator map, pass fruit map to this. Okay, by using iterator we are going to iterate through this fruit map. Okay, let's see how to iterate through hash map by using iterator. So we have a method called iterator. Okay, we have a method called iterator in the entry set. So first create an iterator. How do we create an iterator? Iterator map dot entry of key comma value. What is the key here? Integer. What is the value? string. So map dot iterator, iterator equal to root map dot entry set dot iterator. Okay, how do we call iterator? How do we create an iterator? So iterator map dot entry of integer comma string fruit map dot entry set dot iterator. We'll be having iterator method on this entry set. Okay. So it will be available in Java dot util package. Let's see how what is the importance of this iterator. Okay. So it iterates over a collection. It iterates over a collection. So iterator takes place of enumeration in Java collections framework. Iterator differs from enumeration in two ways. Okay. It allows the caller to remove elements from the underlying collection during the iteration. So this is one of the best usage of the iterator. So we can remove the elements during iteration. Method names have been improved. So that these are the two advantage. Okay, that is that we have when we use iterator. Now we got the iterator. Now what we need to do in this iterator, we'll get the elements. So just say while iterator dot has next, iterator dot has next map dot entry of key comma value. Key comma, so when we say map iterate map dot entry, okay, and thus call this as an entry. Here key will be integer and value will be string. Okay, so map dot entry of entry is equals to iterator dot next. So when we call iterator dot next, it will give you entry. In this entry we'll be having key and value. Just call sysout key equal to entry dot get key and then value equal to entry dot get value. So you understood, right? First we need to create iterator. So in which method we'll be having iterator? On the map entry set we'll be having the iterator. So once we created an iterator, just call iterator dot has next, okay, on this, and then whenever we call iterator dot has next, we'll get entry. So out of this entry call get key and get value. So now we can print key and value out of this. So I'm just commenting the first one, key set iteration. Why? Because we should know, I mean, whatever the output we got from iterator map is proper or not. So that's the reason I commented first one. Now let's run the program. If you see key equal to 1, value equal to mango, key equal to 2, apple, 3 banana, 4 orange. Okay, so this is the second way of iterating through the map. Now let's see the third method by using entry set. So we have a method called entry set on the map. Okay, we have a method called entry set on the map. So which will be useful to iterate over the hash map. So when we call entry set on the map, it will return entry is nothing but it's a key value pair. Each entry, okay, we call it as, I mean, each key value pair is called as an entry in the map. So we have a method called entry set. So when we iterate through the entry set, we'll get an entry. From that entry we can get key and value. Okay, let's see, this is the third one, entry set map. Pass fruit map values to this. Okay, fruit map values to this entry set map. And let's create a method entry set map. So now iterate through this entry set map. I mean, for each of, okay, on this fruit map, call entry set. As I told you, there is a method called entry set on this fruit map. Okay, so when the entry set will return what? It will return entry. So map dot entry of key comma value integer comma string. Map dot entry of key comma value, call this as an entry. Now let's print the key and value out of this entry. So when we say entry dot get key, okay, get key, it will return key from the map. So key value equal to, key value equal to entry dot get key, and then call value. So now we got first key value, now we'll get the value, entry dot get value. Okay, now let's run the program and see the output. So this is the demo of entry set method, how to iterate using map using entry set. Let's run the program and see the output. Key value equal to 1, value equal to mango. Key value equal to 2, value equal to apple. Key value equal to 3, value equal to banana. Key value equal to 4, value equal to orange. Okay, hope you understand this video. Okay, so this is very one of the important, I mean, if you follow this video, right, mostly we'll be seeing all the important methods of the map. So you'll be very good on the maps concept. Why? Because you'll be knowing all the methods. So now we have seen the third method. Let's see the fourth method using streams. What is the fourth method? Using streams. So using streams in Java 8, we can iterate through the map. So I'm saying streams of fruit map. I'm just calling this method as streams of fruit map. Let's click on this method. Call this as create method. Okay, let's create the method by using streams, how to iterate through the map. So how do you use streams on in Java 8? Okay, so when we call stream, okay, in Java 8, right, we have a method called entry set. On the entry set, we can call stream method. Okay, so when we say streams, right, fruit map dot entry set dot stream, okay, on this stream, by using for each loop, we can get the key and value. Okay, I'll show you how to get that. So fruit map dot entry set dot stream dot for each, okay, dot for each, fruit map dot entry set dot stream dot for each. So inside this for each, we'll be printing the value of key and value. So by using lambda expression, just say for each like this. Okay, so first what we need to do, fruit map dot entry set, we have a method called entry set on the map, and on this entry set we have a method called stream, and on this stream we are looping using for each method. Okay, just call system dot out dot println, system dot out dot println e dot get key and e dot get value. E dot get key and e dot get value. Let's see, we are getting some error, and let's figure out what is the error and fix this. Insert. Okay, let me see. I mean, where this is missing. We have this here. System.out.println e dot get key and then e dot get value. Okay, now understood. Since we have two lines, right, we need to open the flower braces. So instead of that, we can also do like this: e dot get key space, let's call value equal to e dot get value. Let's remove this line. Okay, now e dot get key and e dot get value, but still we see one more compilation error here. We'll see syntax error on semicolon. Okay, we need not put any semicolon over here inside the lambda expression, that means inside this for each loop. Okay, so now we have resolved the compilation errors. So let's see what the output is. Here we'll add key equal to, let's run the program and see the output. Key equal to 1, value equal to mango. Key equal to 2, value equal to apple. Key equal to 3, value equal to banana. Key equal to 4, value equal to orange. Since we have not commented the entry set map, we got the two outputs. If we comment this, we'll get only one output, which we iterated using streams, we'll get only that output. Yeah, key equal to 1, value equal to mango, key equal to 2, yeah. Okay, now you understood, right? So this is the iteration using Java 8 streams. This is the fourth method. And let's see the fifth method. So this is one of the easiest way using for each. Using for each method, this is one of the easiest way to loop through the map. Okay, so this is also using Java 8. So then we'll see, I mean, this is also using Java 8, this is also using Java 8. So when we should use streams? So this is best way to filter collection or filter map. If you want to filter some data by looping this map, this is the best way. Okay. Now say Java 8 using for each loop, just call pass the fruit map to this method. And then let's create a method on this. So on this map, we have on this map, just call for each. We have a method called for each. So in this for each, we need to define the action key comma value. So we can say key comma value, and then by using the lambda expression, okay, just by using the lambda expression, print the value of key and value. System dot out dot println key equals to, and then system dot out dot println value equals to, okay, key comma value. let's see why we are getting the error. Key cannot be resolved to a variable, value cannot be resolved to a variable, and then semicolons. So why we are getting this compilation error means we don't have open parenthesis over here and closed parenthesis over here. So all this should be inside this for each. So that is the reason we got the compilation error. So this is one of the simple and best way by using for each method on this fruit map. And if you don't have anything to filter or anything to remove, any operations we need not perform, in that case we can use this. Now let's run the program and see the output. Sorry, key equal to value equal to, I didn't mention that. What is the key here? Key and then value equal to value. Let's run the program and see the output. So key equal to 1, value equal to mango, key equal to 2, value equal to apple. Okay, so this is how by using Java 8 for each loop we can iterate to the map. So this is the sixth way. And let's see the seventh way. Sorry, sixth, I mean this is using fifth way by using for each. Let's see the last way by using for each. Using for each, using stream, using entry set, using key set, using iterator. So these are the five different ways. So I mentioned it wrong, six ways. So actually these are the five different ways to iterate over hash map. So if you learn this video, you'll be knowing all the methods inside a map, as well as you'll become master on the map. So what all concepts we have learned? How to create a map, how to add elements into the map, okay, how to get the elements from the map, how to iterate through the map. So all these operations we have learned, okay, by using this video. Hope you understand this video. Thanks for watching this video. If you like my videos, don't forget to subscribe to my videos. So in the description I have mentioned the Telegram group. If you want to learn, I mean if you want any videos on Java, or if you want important materials, or if you want to know any latest jobs in Java, you can join that group. Thanks for watching this video.